Hi everyone, this is Mona. Welcome back. In this video, we want to cover the basics of unit conversion. I think this can be useful for courses like chemistry, physics, or anything that involves basically unit conversion. So what we are going to cover in this video is like smaller units and larger units, and how to do the single unit conversions and how to do the multi-unit conversions. So this is an example, like liter is a unit for volume. So in this example, we want to see what smaller units than liters we have and then what larger units we have. So on the right hand side, you can see all the smaller units like deci, centi, milli, micro, nano, and pico. And then on the left hand side, you can see the larger units than liters. So it's kiloliters, megaliters, gigaliters, and teraliters. So my way of doing these is basically going from a larger unit to a smaller unit because it's I can understand it or picture it better. So you can say for every 1 liter, for example, you have 10 deciliters, or for example, for every 1 liter, you have 100 centiliters, or for every liter, you have basically 1,000 milliliter, and so on. So as you can see, you can say from a liter, which is a larger unit, you can go to the smaller units and multiply it by that 10 to the power of whatever that is. On the other hand, on the left hand side, we actually have the larger units. So it's easier to go again from the larger ones to the smaller ones. So for example, going from kiloliters to liters. So for every kiloliters, you have 10 to the 3 liters. For every megaliters, you have 10 to the 6 liters, and so on. So yeah, again, as I noted, the smaller units are on the right hand side, the larger units are on the left hand side. So this is another example. This is the conversion for mass. The unit for mass is grams. So we can see smaller units than grams, which is decigrams, centigrams, milligrams, micro, nano, and pico. And then same thing on the left, or larger units than kilos. So same way, same conversion, basically. Doesn't matter whichever SI unit you're dealing with. If it's the unit for mass, it's the unit for volume, the distance, whatever it is, you can actually convert it the same way. So yeah, for every one large one, you have that many smaller pieces in there. Or you can say, referring to the left hand side, those are larger units. So for every one larger unit, like teragrams, you have 10 to the 12, for example, grams, and so on. So to continue, we can now try showing you some conversions, how to actually do the conversion. So when converting, always start from what you have, and in the next round, use the same unit again in order to have it canceled. So this is an example. If they give you 35 milliliters and you want to convert it to kiloliters, so start with whatever the question has given you. Your next step should be having the milliliters in the bottom and then putting whatever unit that you know milliliters can can be converted to straight on the top. So you know for every, for example, 1 liter, you have 1,000 milliliters. So by doing so, you're actually canceling milliliters and you end up getting liters on top. But we don't want to stop here because we want to go to kiloliters on next step. So next step would be having liters down this time to get it canceled out, and then having kiloliters actually up. So we know again, for every one larger unit, 1 kiloliter, we have 1,000 liters basically. So this way things can get cancelled, and then we end up getting to the final answer in kiloliters basically. Here's another example. For example, converting 2.7 gigaliters to nanoliters. So giga is a large unit and then nano is a very tiny unit. So we want to start with 2.7 given. First step would be to get rid of the gigaliter again, so gigaliter has to be down, and then whichever unit we know we can convert it to straight has to go up. In this case would be the liters again, so we know for every 1 gigaliters we have 10 to the 9 liters. Next step would be to get rid of the liter now, putting liters down and then putting nanoliters up. So we know for every 1 liter there's 10 to the 9 nanoliters. So this way we're basically canceling gigaliters with each other, liters with each other, and we're going to end up getting the nanoliter. So this would be our final answer. Now let's try doing an example with 2 units conversion. For example, if they give me 25 kilograms per milliliter and we want to convert it to centigrams per liter. So we have to either focus on the top, unit first or the bottom unit first. In this example, I'm getting rid of the top unit first and then taking care of the bottom unit. So for example, if we're getting from kilograms to centigrams, I can go straight. So what I do is I first convert it to grams. So I know for every 1 kilogram, I have 1,000 grams. And then I would have another step going from grams to centigrams. So this way, just to get rid of this grams, I have to have the grams going down and centigram going up. Again, as you can see, I'm always putting one for the larger unit, smaller, like a lot of smaller units, smaller, like a huge number for the smaller unit, basically. So this way we can see kilograms are canceling out, grams are canceling out, and we end up getting the centigram that we want on the top. But then next move should be to get rid of the milliliter in the bottom and then convert that to liters. So we have to, in order to do so, we have to put the milliliters up and then liter has to come down. But then the ratio we have this time is for every 1 liter, we know it's 1,000 milliliters. So this way, basically, we see the milliliters canceling out and then liter would end up being in the bottom. So this would be our final answer with the 2 unit on it. So this is another example going from mass of water, for example, finding the mass of water using the volume of water, basically. So this time the density of water is given, which is the based on the unit. You don't, even if you don't know what density is, based on the unit, you can already know what to do. So because we have the milliliters first, we have to start with that. And as I say, I always start with something that has one single unit. For example, in this case, density has 2 units, and then volume of water, 250 milliliters, is just 1 unit. It's always best to start with the 1 unit thing. So you start with 250 milliliters. Your next step should be to get rid of the milliliters. And then because the density is given, we know the ratio of milliliters to grams. So we know for every 1 gram, there's 1 milliliter. So this would be your final answer, and this way they get canceled out. By the way, if you want to know the sig fig rules, significant figure rules, I have another video. You can go and check it out, and you get that information about that as well. I'm not really focusing on the sig fig in this video, but yeah, keep that in mind. So there's another example. This time you want to find a volume of 26 kilograms of water, again using the density of water. So if you have 26 kilograms, because the density is written based on grams, we have to convert kilograms to grams. So we start with 26. Next step is to get rid of the kilograms and convert it to grams. And now that we have that, next step would be having the grams down, milliliters of water up. So this way the grams, they're going to cancel out, kilograms are going to cancel out, and then we're going to end up with the milliliter of water. So that was it. I hope this video was useful. Thanks for watching. See you guys soon. Bye bye.